I got that momentum, not knowing when I'm ever gonna slow up in 'em. Ready to snap any momentum, thinking it's time to go get 'em. They ain't gonna know what hit 'em when they get beat with the rhythm. I got that momentum, not knowing when I'm ever gonna slow up. Welcome, Toy Biz Marvel Legend fans. Today we have a beautiful review here, and I have Ina alongside of me. I bought this figure in Florida. Where did I buy this
Syracuse.
One?
Syracuse.
Okay, you know what? Syracuse. You know, I'm so sorry, guys. I tend to kind of forget, you know, where I get these figures at times. But, yeah, this figure was on sale, and it says VNC Collectibles. That's the name of the store. The packaging is really, really in bad, bad shape. But nonetheless, you know, this is like the lady version of Bishop. Her name is Future Shard. This is the review for Future Shard, guys. And thank you for joining me each and every Friday, guys. Usually I try to put out a new video every Friday or at least once a week, but mostly Fridays. And I'm glad that you guys are able to tune in and check out the reviews, check out the new in-the-box figures that I'm doing, a lot of them. And then soon enough, we'll be tackling the loose figures that I buy too. But anyways, guys, this is Future Shard. I like this figure a lot. And the packaging is really bad. And actually, yes, it is in Florida. Now that I remember, it was in Florida that I got this, because this figure has a really, really nasty packaging. And that's how I remember that's from Florida. And I got a good deal on it just because of that. So $2.99 is good. So yeah, this is the front of it. And I don't know why it's so like this, the plastic part of the figure. So, you know, the boxing is really bad. I think maybe it was in a smoke area, and maybe it got colored that way. I don't know exactly why it's like that. But here's the back of the packaging. As you can see, there is Future Wolverine to collect on the series, Future Apocalypse, Future Bishop, and Future Shard, of course. And yeah, this is the line that you could actually collect. So, you know, if you're into these figures, I just got her because I like her. I like the way that she looks, and I feel like she'll fit into scale, you know, with the rest of them, you know, the Marvel Legends that I have. So yeah, I'm really glad to show you this guy. So let me turn it around, and Ina, so go ahead and say to the fans out here exactly what's cool about this figure here, what you like so far.
What's cool about this figure is that she has a little ponytail in the back of her head.
That's right, guys. There is a ponytail. It's kind of like braided, and it's kind of hard to make out, but when I, you know, unbox it, which is almost unboxed already because it's such poorly, in such poor condition packaging, I will show you that. And really, there's nothing that much more left to see. There's like Wolverine in the background there with some missiles, and it says X-Men missile flyers, and it says with a spring-loaded wing pack. So that's cool, guys. So let's break this thing open and see how it looks out of the packaging.
And here she is, guys, out of the packaging. I really love this figure. She's super cool. As you can see, her suit, it's super cool. I like the yellow stripes. The boots are cool. I like that. It's everything about her is cool. And if you can see right there, she got like kind of, I don't know what that is. It's cool though.
Yeah, she's got some really good paint detail, guys. I really admire this this work here. I'm not sure what artist designed this, but whoever it was, they did a great job. I like the way they have the small X-Men logos all, you know, in two places there in the front there. And I like the way they had the orangey on a red orangey on the bottom of the boots. That's really cool detail too. There's not really much shading going on, but if you look really closely, guys, here on the face, she has like the same marks as Bishop on the face. Like, it's like almost like an M or something. I don't know what it stands for. I forgot. But if any of you know what that stands for, please let me know in the comments. And, you know, here's the back of her, really beautifully detailed on the back and everything. Very nice. And then you got the X-Men logo right there again. And then kind of like something there on her belt. Really nice, guys. I'm really happy to do the review on this one. And the face is so nicely detailed for the time. I think this came out around, I'm trying to get a good focus on this. So look at the face. Oh, went off focus again. Trying to get on focus. Hold on. It's terrible. Today the camera does not want to work good. Okay, there we go. Like the face. I think that it's a very pretty figure. Very nice. Nicely done figure. So yeah, guys, I she's probably from the comics, and I don't know what comics that she came out in, like her first appearance, but I'm pretty sure that she's from the comics, and she made an appearance maybe a few times, during the old times, maybe the 90s or something, I want to say. And there's an accessory over here. It's kind of like a kite thingy majig. I don't know. I'm not going to use these. I store them away so I don't lose them. That's all. And then comes with a couple missiles right over here. And yeah, that's about it. But yeah, I admire, the design of the way they did the hair and everything. I really like that. And I like the dark blue color that they use. Color scheme is very nicely done. And yeah, guys, that's a pretty short review here because, it is a small figure. But nonetheless, I'm really happy to own her. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And tune in next time. I'm going to be having a few more other reviews. I'm going to be doing one on Black Bolt. And there's another one called Lunatica. Please stay tuned for that. And yeah, guys, please join me next time. And see you later.